Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial. From this video, we start a new series, Riemann Integration. Let us see the first definition of Riemann Integration. Partition of a closed interval. Partition of a closed interval. Let us consider a closed interval closed interval a comma b, where both a comma b belongs to capital R and a less than b. Let us consider a closed interval a comma b, where a comma b are real numbers such that a less than b. If there exists some numbers between A and B, if A is equals to x0 less than x1 less than x2 less than and so on less than xr less than and so on less than xn minus 1 less than xn, which is equals to B. If there exist some points x0 is equals to a and x0 less than x1, x1 less than x2 and so on less than xr and so on less than xn minus 1 less than xn. Observe that xn is equals to b. Then the finite set capital P is equals to set of all these points x0 comma x1 comma x2 comma and so on xr comma and so on xn. Then the finite set P is equals to x0 x1 x2 and so on xn is said to be the partition of the closed interval a comma b. Observe the definition. Let us consider a closed interval a comma b, where a comma b are real numbers with the property a less than b. If there exist some points x0, x1, x2 and so on xn having this property a is equals to x0, x0 less than x1, x1 less than x2 and so on less than xn minus 1 less than xn is equals to b, then the finite set P is equals to x0, x1, x2 and so on xr and so on xn is said to be the partition of the closed interval a comma b. Observe that. Here the n plus 1 points, you observe that how many points are there? How many numbers are there? x0, x1, x2 and so on xn. The n plus 1 points of P are known as partition points. The n plus one points x0 comma x1 comma x2 comma and so on xn are known as partition points. These are known as partition points. With this n plus 1 points, by using these n plus 1 points, x0, x1, x2 and so on, xn, we can form n subintervals for the closed interval a comma b. This is very, very important point. Remember that. By using these n plus 1 points, we can form n subintervals of closed interval a comma b as closed interval x0 comma x1, closed interval x1 comma x2, closed interval x2 comma x3 and so on, closed interval xn minus 1 comma xn. By using these n plus 1 points, x0, x1, x2 and so on, xn, we can form n subintervals of closed interval a comma b like this. The first one is known as, they are denoted by like this, I1, first subinterval, I2, second subinterval, I3, third subinterval, In, nth subinterval. In general, the in between, by using rth term, IR is equals to XR minus 1 comma XR, which is known as rth subinterval, which is known as rth subinterval, rth subinterval of closed interval A comma B, of closed interval A comma B. These subintervals, these, observe that there are n plus 1 points. There are n plus 1 points. By using n plus 1 points, you can form only n subintervals. These n subintervals are known as, these n subintervals are said to be, segments. S-E-G-M-E-N-T-S are said to be segments, or it has another name, components. Segments are components of the, segments are components of the partition P. Observe that. These are very, very important terminology to remember while learning the Riemann integration. So, by using n plus 1 points, which are known as partition points, you can form n subintervals of closed interval a comma b. You can form n subintervals for the closed interval a comma b. All these are I1, I2, IR and so on, IN. They are subintervals to the closed interval a comma b. They are subsets. Subintervals to the closed interval a comma b, and also these subintervals are known as segments. In other words, they are known as components of the partition P. You observe that it has little bit importance. The rth subinterval of closed interval a comma b. Important point. The rth subinterval is denoted by, IR, that is, IR is equals to closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR, and its length, its length is defined as XR minus XR minus 1, and it is denoted by, delta R, or capital delta R, that is, small delta r is equals to xr minus 1. Observe that this symbol has a lot of importance. Delta r, which is equals to length of, rth subinterval, ir, which is equals to closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR, and defined as XR minus 1 for all R various from 1 comma 2 comma and so on small n. Observe that IR means rth subinterval. It is denoted by closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR. The length is defined as, the length of the rth subinterval is defined as XR minus 1 comma XR. The length of the rth subinterval is denoted by the symbol delta R. That is, delta R is equals to length of rth subinterval
which is equals to xr minus xr minus 1 for all r is equals to 1 to and so on small n. Observe that. It means, what it means? Delta 1 is equals to length of the first subinterval. Delta 1 is equals to length of first subinterval I1, which is equals to x1 minus x0. Delta 2 is equals to length of I2, which is equals to x2 minus x1. Delta 3 is equals to length of I3, which is equals to x3 minus x2, and so on. Delta n is equals to length of in, nth subinterval, I1, first subinterval, I2, second subinterval, I3, third subinterval, and so on, IR, rth subinterval, in, nth subinterval, xn minus 1. This is known as length of the subintervals. Yes. Let us go for next point. The maximum of the lengths, again important point, the maximum of the lengths, the maximum of the lengths of the n subintervals of closed interval a comma b, the maximum of the lengths of the n subintervals of closed interval a comma b corresponding to the partition p is known as one of the very very important definition. The maximum of the lengths of the subintervals of closed interval a comma b corresponding to the partition p is known as norm of the partition p, and it is denoted by double mod p, but read as norm p, denoted by double mod p and read as norm p. It has another symbol also, delta of p, that is norm p is equals to length of the maximum of the lengths of the subintervals. Delta is equals to, norm p is equals to maximum of the length of the subintervals, that is equals to maximum of delta 1 comma delta 2 comma delta 3 comma delta r comma and so on delta n. We know that these are delta 1, delta 2 and so on, delta r, nothing but lengths of the subintervals. So norm p is equals to maximum of delta 1 comma delta 2 comma and so on delta r, which is also known as norm of the partition p. One of the important definition, define norm of the partition. Observe that the maximum of the lengths of the n subintervals of closed interval a comma b, here the number is not necessary, the maximum of the lengths of the subintervals of closed interval a comma b corresponding to the partition p is known as norm p or norm of the partition p, and it is denoted by double mod p, but read as norm p. That is, norm p is equals to maximum of delta 1 comma delta 2 comma and so on delta r comma and so on delta n. There is no unique way to define a partition over the closed interval a comma b. a closed interval, that is the, observe that, a closed interval, a closed interval a comma b, closed interval a comma b can be partitioned in infinite number of ways, in infinite number of ways. It means there is no unique way, there is no unique way to define a partition. A closed interval a comma b can be partitioned in infinite number of ways, can be partitioned in infinite number of ways. The set of all partitions, the set of all partitions defined over, the set of all partitions defined over closed interval a comma b, the set of all partitions defined over closed interval a comma b is denoted by the symbol, is denoted by the symbol pi of closed interval a comma b. The set of all partitions defined over the closed interval a comma b is denoted by the symbol pi of a comma b. Suppose if another point if p1 comma p2 are two partitions defined over the same closed interval, defined over the same closed interval a comma b, such that p1 comma p2 both are partitions defined over the same closed interval a comma b, such that they have one property, p1 is subset to p2, then the partition p2 is called finer than p1. In such a case, we said that p2 is refinement of p1, that is p2 is refinement of p1. So if the partition p1 subset to p2, it means p2 is finer than p1. In such a case, that p2 is known as refinement of the partition p1. Refinement of the partition p1. Observe that. If p2 is refinement of p1 means, p2 is refinement of p1 means, p2 contains all the points of p1 and also some other points which are not lies in p1. P2 is refinement of p1 means, p2 contains all the points of p1 and also some another points which does not lies in p1, which does not lies in p1. And from here you observe one more point. P1 union P2 is refinement. In other words, common refinement. P1 union P2 is known as common refinement of partitions P1 comma P2. The word common refinement, observe that. P1 union P2 is known as common refinement of the partitions P1 comma P2. Another point. If P1 is subset to P2, then norm P2 is less than or equals to norm P1. This is converse. Remember that. If P1 is subset to P2, then norm P2 is less than or equals to norm P1. Norm P2 is less than or equals to norm P1. It means P2 contains some another points which are not lies in P1. It means norm of the P2 is always less than or equals to norm P1. Right. And finally, the last important point, summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r. Summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r. It means, what is delta r? Length of the subinterval. Length of the rth subinterval. It means, delta 1 plus, delta 2 plus, delta 3 plus and so on plus delta n. Which, what is delta 1? Actually, delta 1 is equals to length of I1. I1 is equals to x0, x1. Delta 2 is equals to length of I2. What is I2? X1. Closed interval x1, x2. Delta 3 is equals to length of I3. What is I3? Closed interval x3, x2. Now you observe, what is the length of this one? X1 minus X0. What is the length of delta 2? What is X2 minus X1? What is this? X3 minus X2. Substitute that points. X1 minus X0 plus X2 minus X1 plus X3 minus plus X3 minus X2 plus and so on plus Xn minus 1. Every term get cancelled. You get xn minus x0. According to closed interval a comma b and the partition p, xn is equals to b, x0 is equals to a. Therefore, summation r is equals to 1 to n, delta r is equals to b minus a. Delta r is equals to b minus a. Observe that. Delta r is equals to b minus a. Summation r is equals to 1 to n. Summation r is equals to 1 to n, delta r is equals to b minus a. And remember that, if the norm of the partition tends to 0, if the norm of the partition tends to 0, this is also important point, if the norm of the partition tends to 0, then the partition P contains infinite number of points. So, norm of the partition 0. The norm of the partition 0 means the partition P contains infinite number of points. The partition P contains infinite number of points. Observe that in this video, we learn the definition of the partition. We learn the definition of the partition. And we learn about partition points. We learn about subintervals. We learn about the length of the subintervals. We learn about common refinement and also sum of the lengths. So, different points you can learn. So, this is the terminology which will be more useful to us while learning the Riemann integration. Keep learning, familiar with these definitions, then it is very easy to understand the Riemann integration. In the next video, we learn about upper Riemann integral, upper Riemann sum and lower Riemann sum. Keep learning.